Jesus Christ, the rock of ages. Jesus Christ, the builder. Jesus Christ, the founder. Jesus Christ, the cornerstone of our faith. Let's step back 2,000 years, back to the ancient city of Jerusalem. Let us tell you his story. As his story unfolds, we see crowded streets, for the city of Jerusalem is filled with excitement. It's the Passover season. Everyone seems to be talking about this Jesus, a prophet from Nazareth. A triumphant march is heard as he majestically rides through crowds. Listen, and if you listen further, you'll hear the people thronging the way, singing, "Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King. Praise how we sing. Glory to the King.
just a prophet. Others say he's just a man. And some say he's just a teacher, doing good throughout the land. But those who heard the master say, peace be still, one stormy day, turn to each other, and you could hear them say, change the sinful wretch like me. And although I can't explain, my life's different since he came.
There's something different about the one whose name is Jesus.
He was only 33 years old as he rode triumphantly through that palm-waving, cheering crowd that day. Some who cheered had watched him grow up in Galilee, and it's even possible that some of the Bethlehem shepherds were there. They had all heard about, and most had witnessed, his miracles. They were fascinated by his teachings. They'd heard his wisdom, they felt his warmth and his love. But none knew what that love could cost him in the days that followed. They only knew there was something, different about him. Jesus. Only 4 days have passed since his triumphal entry into Jerusalem. The mood of the people is changing drastically. The cheering crowds are gone, and the religious leaders, feeling threatened by this prophet from Galilee, have begun plotting to take his life. They bribe one of his own disciples to betray him. He and the others are gathered in an upper room to observe the feast of the Passover. It will be the last meal our Lord will share with this very special group of friends. Listen, as the master asked a very pointed question.
Above.
tried so many ways to show you my love and show you who I am. Sometimes I've wondered if you've ever heard or if you understand. Body that is broken for you. Never forget what I've done. This is my blood that is shed for you. This is what makes us one.
And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus stopped at the entrance to a garden called Gethsemane. There, he told them to sit down and to wait while he went on alone to pray. Twice he returned to find them sleeping, and finally the agony of his burden was so great that he told them to sleep on and take their rest. And he returned to pray alone. his praying was interrupted when Judas arrived with soldiers armed with swords. They forcefully took Jesus to the home of Caiaphas, the high priest, where he was falsely accused, slapped, and spat in his face. They tormented him till morning, and then he was bound with chains and sent to Pilate, the Roman governor.
Find no fault in this man called Jesus, the healer from the shores of Galilee. I command you to ask me to let him go free. Don't let me take his blood to the grave with me.
Thank you.
Jesus cried with a loud voice,
"Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit."
And with those words, he died.
Thank you.
after his death by crucifixion, Joseph of Arimathea, who had been a secret disciple, boldly asked Pilate for permission to take the body down. And then with Nicodemus, they wrapped Jesus in a long linen grave cloth and placed his body in a new tomb. The Roman government sealed that tomb before the Sabbath and posted guards to keep the disciples from taking his body away.
Thank you.
but the story of Jesus Christ doesn't end with his resurrection. Thank God there's still another chapter. Remember his words to his disciples and to us? Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, and I will come again to receive you, that where I am, there you will be also. Go then into all the world and preach the gospel to everyone everywhere. And those who believe and are baptized will be saved. And when Jesus had finished talking with them, he was taken up into heaven, and he sat down at the right hand of God the Father to become our cornerstone.